The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 5th chapter, text number 7 through 14, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in August of 1966 in New York.
Yoga-yukta visuddhātmā viditātmā jitendriya सर्वभूतात्मा भूतात्मा कुर्बन्नपि न लिप्यते। डिटैचमेंट सन्यासस्तु महाबाहो दुःखम आत्मजुगता योग युक्त मुनि ब्रह्म न शिवेन अधिगच्छति। वन वी हैव बीन डिस्कशन दैट सन्यास Renouncement of the world, not by artificial dress, but actually renouncement is described here in yoga-yukta. That means we have to stay in the Krishna consciousness, then we can renounce. Otherwise it is not possible. If I am to vacate this room, then I must have some other room to stay there. Otherwise it is not possible for me to leave this room. That is the nature of living entities. They want some engagement. They want some simple negative consideration that I want to detach. Oh, that will not make me happy. I must have some attachment also. I detach from this place by attach myself to that place. Because I am eternal. I am the eternal living entity. My symptom is eternity. Not that I detach and end myself. No. I continue to exist. So, without attachment, we cannot actually be detached from this material world. The sannyasasya mahabha, if artificially I detach myself, renounce this world, then Krishna says, dukkham aptam ajugata. If there is no engagement, good engagement, better engagement, then it is a cause of misery. It is a cause of misery. It is very difficult. Suppose a family man, he renounces the family connection. But if he has no better connection and better attachment, then he will feel, though I was better in my family life, I have done mistake. So Krishna says, sannyasastu mahabaho dukkhamaptum ajogata. Ajogata means if you have no link with the Krishna consciousness, then simply detachment will be cause of misery. Dukkham aptam. It will be cause of misery. Yoga yukta muni brahma. But one who is dogged with the Supreme, yoga yukta muni brahma atirena adhigacchati brahma. Yoga yukta. If I am dogged with Krishna consciousness, then atirena. Achidana means very soon I shall realize myself as Brahma. I am Brahma. It is simply a question of realization. By misconception, by illusion, I am thinking that I am matter. But actually I am Brahma. The whole process is to realize that I am Brahma, I am not this matter. This conception, Brahma conception, or realization, self-realization, is possible, yoga-yukta, uniform, always dotted with Krishna consciousness. If I am always dotted with Krishna, doing something in connection with Nidbandhi, Krishna Sambandhi, Jutta Vairagya Muchchati. The other day, I tried to explain this verse of Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami, he has stated in two ways the attachment and detachment. He says, anāsaktasya viṣayāṁ jathāraṁ upajanjaṁ. Viṣayāṁ, the things of our enjoyment, that should be accepted anāsaktasya, without any attachment. I require this for maintenance of my body, therefore I accept this. This is called anāsaktasya. In other words, just to make the better use of a bad body. I am now materially encased, so I must make the best use of this body by dovetailing myself in Krishna, Krishna Sambandhi, Nirbandhi Krishna Sambandhi. And another verse Rupa Goswami is saying, prapanchikataya buddhya pari sambandhina bhastuna. Mumukshubi parityaga phalgu vairagyam tatsate prapanchikataya buddhya. Just like there are some philosophers, they say that this material world is false and Brahma is real. Of course that is all right. But according to Vaishnava philosophy as we say that material world is not false, but it is temporary. That if you say temporary thing as false, that is not the right nomenclature. Temporary, one thing may be temporary, but that is not false. That's like we have come here, I have come from India, I am staying in this room for the last 2 months, or I may stay here for some days more. So my visit, I am a visitor, my visit is temporary. But this temporary visit is not false. Is it false? Oh, I am sitting here, I am talking with you, I am eating so many things. If they are all false? No, they are not false. They are not false, but temporary. Therefore, Hari Sambandhina Bhastuna, everything has got connection with Krishna. That realization is required. Everything. Whatever we see here, they are only perverted reflection of the reality. This perverted reflection, I have tried to explain many times. It's like if there is a tree on the bank of a lake, you will find the tree is perverted reflected within the water. That means the top has gone to the down and the root has come up. And in the 15th chapter, it is described in that way. So this world is a perverted reflection. And because it is reflection of the reality, therefore it appears so nicely that we take it as actual fact. That is called illusion. But if we understand that it is temporary, I should not be attached to the temple. My attachment should be to the reality, not to the unreality. So reality is Krishna. This is also reality, but temporary. So we have to get ourselves from the temporary to the reality. Therefore, Rupa Goswami says that prapanchikataya buddhya hari sambandhina vastuna. Now in this material world, because this material world is manifestation of the energy of the Supreme Law. Therefore, it has got a very intimate connection with the Supreme Law. It has got connection. Because just like the sun shines, although the sun is far away, but the sun sign has got direct connection with sun. The sun sign is connecting me from this man, earth to the sun, 90 million of miles away. Still have a connection with that. So similarly, this material world is the manifestation of the energy of the Supreme Law. Therefore, it has got intimate relation with the Supreme Law. That we have to understand. We should not take it, accept it as false and reject it. No. We cannot reject it because there is connection with Krishna. Now we have to utilize it properly. Because it has got connection with Krishna. And because it is the energy of Krishna. Therefore the whole thing is that this should be utilized for Krishna. It should be utilized for Krishna. If this material world is utilized for Krishna, then there is no trouble, there is no disturbance of peace. There is always peace and tranquility and happiness in this world and at the same time happiness in the next world. If we consider when I am taking my food, if I think of this nice food stuff is sent by Krishna. He has kindly sent me this food stuff. So I think of Krishna. So that taking of food stuff is Krishna consciousness is yoga yukta. That is called yoga. That is yoga. Always thinking in Krishna consciousness, that is called yoga yukta. Yoga yukta muni. Muni means one who is thoughtful, he is called Muni. So one who is always thoughtful of Krishna, such person, Yogajukta, and Yogajukta Muni, Brahma, Nasirena Abhigacchati, he is very soon, he becomes situated in his Brahma conception of life. And as soon as you are situated in Brahma conception of life, then immediately your effect will be Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma will be joyful. Your material moroseness will go at once. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nasurati will be free from all anxiety. Will be free from all anxiety. And there will be no demand for your sense satisfaction. You'll feel yourself full. Oh, I am full. I have nothing to demand. You see, such day will come. So yoga yukta muni brahma asirena. If we always dovetail ourselves in Krishna consciousness and in that way we prosecute our duty, we don't take that this is false. We take it that is because it has connection with Krishna, so it should be utilized for Krishna. That yoga yukta muni, he at once very nicely, very easily, he realizes Brahma. There are so many other processes, they are trying to realize Brahma for so many years, by meditation, by penance, by this, going to the forest, Himalaya, and so many things. But if one is intelligent enough, always thinking that everything has got connection with Krishna, and it should be utilized for Krishna, then I am Yogajukta, and my Brahma Bhuta, my Brahma realization is within my hand. It is such a nice Yogajukta Visuddhatma, and one who is doctored in such a way, he is Visuddhatma. Visuddhatma, Atma means self, and Visuddha means pure. In pure self, this is that when we think that I am the enjoyer, that is my Atma is covered with dirty things. I am enjoying, I think. But when I think, when I am Yogajukta Krishna, that everything belongs to Krishna, then I am Visuddha. And that is a fact. I am not proprietor, I am not enjoyer. I am allowed to enjoy whatever is allotted to me. Just like any, take for example, foodstuff. You can take foodstuff as much as you require for your maintenance of the body. Now if you take more then he'll be in trouble. And if he take less, then he'll be in trouble. You have to take exactly what is prescribed for you. Just as the elephant. Elephant is taking 100 pounds daily, twice. Once at a time he takes 100 pounds and more than that. And the ant takes only 1 gram. Now if the ant thinks that I shall also take 100 pounds, it is impossible for me. It is impossible. And if the elephant thinks, all right, the ant is taking 1 gram, I shall take one. No, that is. The system is that in God's kingdom, in God's creation, for everybody, there is sufficient food. He takes as much as he requires. No, that is the natural way. In the nature's way, you will find, beginning from the ant to the elephant, they will not take more, they will not take less. If the elephant, he gives 200 pounds foodstuff, he'll take only 100 pounds, that is required. No. Neither he'll take the foodstuff to his place to stock it for next year. No. You see, this pigeons, whenever you give some foodstuff, they take whatever they require, but they don't take anything for the next day. But we are thinking, we have got so much foodstuff. All right, let me eat to the after the my throat and then take something for next day. The next day question should be solved. We shall always depend. We shall always take as much as we require. That is called yoga. Yuktahara viharasya yoga bhavati siddhya. One who is situated just exactly what he needs. Now, the whole world is situated in such a way that everybody, if he takes exactly what he needs and he does not stop, then there is no need. There is no poverty, there is no scarcity. But we do not do that. We stop for black market. No. That is creating. Thinking that this is my problem. If I think that everything, every eatable thing, they are sent by Krishna or God for everyone, let me take whatever I want, then there is peace in the world. Of course that is not possible because it is such a world, that we are always anxious to stop or even to take more, like more than that. Nobody is satisfied. Nobody is satisfied. The yoga jitta visuddhātmā, one who is visuddhātmā, one who is situated in his pure consciousness, then vijitātmā, jitendri. Sit down, don't disturb, sit down. Vijitātmā and jitendri. Jitendri means that greediness, I want more. As soon as he becomes Krishna consciousness, his greediness goes. I don't want that. I don't want it. So if everybody thinks like that I don't want more, then where is the trouble in this world? Now there is no trouble. Because by grace of God, there is enough food, enough sufficient stock. Simply, it is the anomaly of distribution by the human society that is creating one starving and one. And that starvation is also due to his own work. There are so many. But for perfection, a perfection of the world situation, this is it. Yoga jitto visuddhātmā, when he is dovetailed with Krishna consciousness, he is pure soul. Visuddhātmā. And vijitātmā. Vijitātmā means he has control over the body. And jitendriya. Jitendriya means he has conquered over the senses. Jitendriya. Sarva-bhūtātmā bhūtātmā. And he has identified himself with all living entities. Sarva-bhūtātmā bhūtātmā. Kurvannati nalipate. If he works in that condition of life, then he is practically doing nothing. Because we are being entangled in this material world and according to the reaction of my own work. So, if I am situated in this Krishna consciousness, and I am in my Atma, I am in pure state of my Atma, and I am controlling my body and senses, and I identify each man, every body, every living entity, then I have no entanglement, no reaction of my will. In this state, Krishna says, naiva kinchit karomiti yukta manneta tattavi. I am not doing anything. That is it. A Krishna conscious person, he never thinks that I am doing something. Even if you ask him that, are you going to the certain such place? Suppose it is settled that he is going to certain such place. If you ask him when you are going, he will say that I do not know when I shall go, but when Krishna will ask me or allow me to go, I shall go. This I am saying this from my practical experience, from my Guru Maharaj, from my spiritual master. He will never say that I am doing. So, if Krishna desires, then I shall do it. If Krishna desires, then I shall go. Like that. Always depending on Krishna. This is called Vishuddha. Naiva kinchit karomiti jitta manneta tattavi. This tattavi, tattavi means one who knows the truth. One who knows the truth. The truth is that unless Krishna allows me to go, I may not go. There may be so many obstacles on my path. I have made my whole program. It's like last year, there was an aircraft on the Switzerland, an Indian aircraft, and there were all respectable gentlemen, and there was, perhaps you know it, there was one Indian chemist, Mr. Dr. Bhava. He was going to attend some nuclear meeting in some European country, but there was a crash, and all of them died in a second. So unless Krishna desires, unless he allows, we cannot do anything. We cannot do. This is a fact. So tattvavid means one who knows the truth. They think like that I cannot do anything. I am always dependent on Krishna. I cannot. Mahatma Gandhi, he used to say that not a blade of grass moves without the sanction of God. Yes, it is a fact. It is a fact. Nothing can be done without his sanction. Then you can ask that why somebody is doing bad work and why somebody is doing good work. In both ways Krishna has sanctioned. Yes, in both ways Krishna. Without sanction, he cannot do it. But how both ways Krishna has sanction? Now Krishna has sanction in this way. He has given you liberty. He has given you independence. Not full independence, but you cannot become full independent. But you have got independence. He does not touch on your independence. That is, because otherwise, if you are bereft of your independence, if you are without independence, that you have no meaning as living entity. Every living entity has got its minute share of independence. So Krishna has given every one of you an independence to make your choice. Now, why you are, somebody is doing bad work or somebody is doing good work and Krishna giving sanction? How is that? The sanction is like that, that when I want to do something I desire, I pray, this thing may be done. It may be bad or good, that is different. It may be. I am very much anxious. So when he is bent upon doing so, the Krishna gives him sanction. Yes, you do it. You do it. He gives him facility. But one who has doctored himself into Krishna consciousness, Krishna gives him better sansa that he do like this when he comes to. The sanction is always there. Sanction is always there. Without sanction, nothing can be done. So, one who is in Krishna consciousness, he knows if he is Tattvavit. Tattvavit means one who knows the truth, that I cannot do anything without Krishna's sanction. Therefore, he does not do anything. And whatever is sanctioned by Krishna, he does, otherwise not. So, pashyan, sinnan, swishan, jighran, nasnan, gachan, tapan, asan. These are our activities. Pashyan, we act by seeing, we act by hearing, we act by touching, we act by smelling, we act by going, we act by dreaming, we act by breathing. So many our activities are. So in all these going on, that a sattva, one he is in the perfect knowledge and in Krishna consciousness, he, although he is doing all these things, he knows I am not doing. This is sattva. Although he is doing all these things, he knows that I am not doing. Krishna is doing. I am simply instrumental. I am simply instrumental. That is the connection. So, prapan, visijan, grinnan, unvishan, mishan api, indriyani indriyathisu, vatsanta iti dharayan. Indriyani indriyathisu, there are senses. So, they have got use. So, even the sattva-vid, who is in perfect knowledge, he is also using his senses, but he knows that Krishna is the proprietor of the senses, and he is instrumental only as he is directing my senses at work. Or in other words, when our senses work in that direction of Krishna consciousness, then we gradually make progress to back to Godhead, back to home, and to liberation. Brahmani adhaya karmani sangam tatta taruti ja lipati nasa papina padma patra nidam vasa. There is a very good example here that lotus flower and lotus and leaves of the lotus stem. So, if you put some water, that water does not stick into the lotus leaves. In natural, by natural way, it will not touch. It will never be moist. Similarly, just like the lotus flower leaf does not mash, although it is in the water. Lotus flower is in the water, and the leaves are also in the water. But it has no connection in the water. Even a drop of water, if you put on it, it will at once fall. Lotus, it is made by nature. So here the same example is there, that although we may be in this material world, so because I am staying in Krishna consciousness and I am acting under the direction of Krishna, therefore nothing will affect me. Nothing will affect me. Because due to this material effect and contamination, I am in trouble. Now, I am getting this body one after another, just like changing dress. So, myself, the pure spirit, soul, so I am now in contamination because I am absorbed in the material consciousness. As soon as I transform myself into Krishna consciousness, then I become aloof from this material. Just like the example is given here, the leaf of the lotus flower, although it is in the water, it has no connection with it. Not a drop of water will stay. Not a drop, even a drop. Although it is in a huge mass of water, there is waves are going over it, and so many things, water, and it is moving always, but the that particular leaf of lotus flower, it has no connection. Similarly, with all our fears of this material world, one way, Krishna consciousness, sukha. He has nothing to do. Vishram purnam sukhayate. Vishram purnam sukhayate. Everyone is very much afflicted. They say, oh, it is very troublesome. It is very troublesome what word. It is very troublesome. But a man who is in Krishna consciousness, he will find, oh, everything is happy. There is no... So, na nipate, nasa papena. And this contamination is, that is, Krishna consciousness is the antiseptic measure. Suppose there is some epidemic in the city, and one has taken the antiseptic vaccine or measure, he is not affected. Similarly, this Krishna consciousness is the antiseptic method to become free from the contamination of this material world. So, lippate nasa papena, he is not affected by the counteraction or contamination of this material.
Kaina manasabhya kevale indriyapi yogina karma kurvanti sangam tasya atma shuddha. Atma shuddha.
Yogina, those who are yogi. Yogi means those who are in connection with the Supreme, they are called yogi. So, kaina, kaina means by body. Manasa, manasa means by mind. Buddha, by Buddha means by intelligence. Kevale indriyapi, and with the senses. Yogina karma kurvanti. They work. It appears just like they are doing like ordinary man. But sangam tatya, atma-suddha. Sangam tatya, atma, he has no connection. He has no connection. Just like a bank cashier. He is sitting on the cash counter and millions of dollars are coming to him, but he has no connection with Atma-siddha, because his yoga-jitta, he knows that I am different from this man. He is all right. So, by Krishna consciousness, one who is a yogi, yogi, yogina karma kudvanti sangam satya, Atma-siddha, Atma-siddha. The karma, they work for Atma-siddhi, just like we are working here. This is also work. We are reading, we are singing. This is also work, a part of work. The same thing can be done in a club, in music. But here the music is for Atma-siddha, for purifying the soul. We are also eating, but for purifying the soul. So, no work is different from the ordinary man. And the members of the society, they are also doing in the same way. They are also going to the store, purchasing things and preparing foodstuff, offering to Krishna, and eating. It appears that they are also eating, they are also sleeping, they are also working. But here, everything is for Atma-siddha. It is under such a regulation that one is becoming purer and purer, purer and purer. So, yogina karma kurvanti. Sangam tatta, it has now connection with the material conception of life. Everything is Krishna conception of life. Therefore, Atma-siddha.
Yutta karma phalam tatya shanti mahatmati naistiki. Ajutta kama karina phale sapta nivandhati.
Those who are in Krishna consciousness, he does not expect any result of it. Oh, I am doing this work, so I will enjoy this result. Oh, that never comes. That never comes in the mind of a person who is Krishna. He doesn't mind. He doesn't think of any result.
Jitta karma phalam takta, and that is the source of peace. Shanti mapnoti, naishti.
He is always confident that I am engaged in Krishna duty. So, I am protected. So, what is the result? I do not mind. I do not mind.
Ajutta.
But one who is not connected in that Krishna consciousness, then kamukarena phale satyanivandhate, he, out of his lust,
he becomes attached to the result, and therefore he becomes entangled in this material.
Ajukta kamkarina phale sakta nivaddhate phale,
because he has got attachment for the result, therefore ultimately he becomes entangled with material world.
Sarvakarma karmani manasa sarnasya asti sukhana mushi navaddari puri dehi naiva sundam nakarani.
So, sarvakarma means manasa sarnasya. Sarvakarma, whatever he does, he has decided. Manasa, by the mind. Determination comes into the mind. Therefore, his determination is manasa asti sukham bashi. He has decided to work only for Krishna consciousness. Therefore, his happiness is under his own control. Happiness is under his own control. He hasn't got to seek happiness external. The happiness is controlled by Sukhana Bashi. Navandari Puri Vehi Naiva Tulban Natara.
So there are nine holes in our body.
So, that nine holes are active. These two eyes, two nostrils, two and two ears, one mouth, and one navel, and the evacuating, and the urinal. There are nine holes, and we are taking work through these nine holes. This room has got four outlets. One there, one here, and two windows. Similarly, we have got nine holes in our body. So you are acting with the help of these nine holes. Navadhari puri dehi, and dehi, it is just like a room having nine outlets. We are not this body, that is must. Navadhari puri dehi. It is pure. Pure means a city or a room. I am sitting within this room. Navadhari puri dehi, turban nakarati. He is doing in the room from this, just like a rich man. He is sitting in his room and everything is going on. Similarly, the soul who is in pure consciousness, Krishna consciousness, he is aloof from this body and everything is going on by Krishna.
Nakastitang nakarmani lokasya srijati prabhu.
Now, you can ask that if Krishna is giving sanction, then he is responsible for my bad work also. Good work, suppose he is responsible. So bad work he is also responsible. Now here the answer is, nakastitang nakarmani lokasya srijati prabhu. Prabhu means the Lord. The Lord does not create work for you, neither he creates the result for you.
Nakarma phalasam yogam sabhavastu pravartate.
Sabhavastu pravartate. As you have acquired your characteristics, so you create your own work and you create your result of one work and you become entangled. It is not the creation of God. You create. How I create? If it is sanctioned, if it is controlled by God, then how I create? The question may be, yes, the answer is very simple. You can understand that a person who is criminal, who is condemned, he is condemned to death, or he is condemned to be imprisoned. Now, he makes a plea. Excuse me, what is that? But the judge puts him into the jail or condemns to life. So he thinks that the judge has condemned me to death or he has put me into jail. But is the judge enemy of a particular person that he puts somebody into the jail and condemns to death?
No.
I have created my jail life before. The judge is simply giving me the direction, you have done this, now you have to go. He is not responsible. Similarly, God is not responsible for my work. Neither He creates my work. It is my nature, it is my characteristic. By which I create my work, I create the result, and I suffer. God will simply give direction, because He is the Supreme Director, or the agent of God. So He is not responsible. I am responsible. But if I become Krishna conscious, if I act on His account and completely becoming dependent on Him, then He is responsible for everything. That is the principle. Any question?
Brahma, would you say self-realization is realizing our identity with Brahma?
Me?
With Brahma. The Brahma dies. Brahma is not eternal.
Brahma is eternal. I'm eternal. I'm thinking, yes.
He's saying Brahma instead of Brahma.
Oh, Brahma, you mean to say?
Oh, you said Brahman.
Brahma is a living creature, just like us, a powerful living creature. He is called Brahma.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He is the first creature. And Brahma is the supreme. Absolutely.